Welcome to our tutorial on the Picot Vision Deep Learning Surface Detection Module. In this video, we'll walk you through setting up a sample inspection, demonstrating how to configure the module to detect and analyze surface defects with precision. This module is designed to identify a wide range of surface defects and requires annotated sample issues to ensure accurate detection of these defects. To start training your dataset, you can either upload your images or capture them from the camera. In our example, we will show how to capture new images from the connected camera. When in the live camera feed view, indicated by the camera icon in the upper left corner, click on the capture icon in the top right corner to take your first image. To create a robust dataset, you'll need to capture several images of the anticipated surface defects, ensuring you include different positions and variations in the background. To achieve this, move and rotate the screws and capture images. To add the surface detection module, go to the top left menu and select the modules option. Click Edit, then the plus button. Choose the surface detection option and click Add. Finally, click Save Changes. To open the module, click on the newly created icon. Now, you need to annotate all the surface defects that you want the trained model to detect. Click Class Manager. Create the first class and name it Scratch. Click plus add class to create the second class, which we will call hole. Click save changes. To start annotating, zoom in using the mouse scroll wheel. We will use the brush annotation tool. You can adjust the brush size using the slider in the top panel or by using a keyboard shortcut. You can find the full list of shortcuts under the question mark icon. To increase the diameter of the brush, press the lowercase L key. To decrease it, press the lowercase K key. Start annotating by holding the left mouse button and moving it along the defect, filling in the inside of the object as well. Switch between the annotation view and defect view using the H key to fine-tune the annotation. To annotate the hole, select hole from the annotation menu. Move to the second image. Zoom in, and annotate the hole in the same way. Next, select Scratch from the annotation menu and choose the polygon tool. Click the left mouse button to start a straight line, move the cursor, and click again to end the line. Move to the next point and click again. If you want the line to follow your cursor in a non-straight path, hold the left mouse button and move the cursor. You can combine these two methods to complete the annotation. When the line meets the initial point, the annotation is complete and will be filled with color. Zoom out. Select the third image, and repeat the same steps for the two remaining images. One annotation tool that may come in handy is the eraser tool. Simply use it to remove any unwanted parts of the annotation. Now, adjust the feature size using the slider. The feature size determines the smallest defects the model can recognize. A smaller feature size allows for the detection of finer defects but requires more computational resources. As a rule of thumb, set the individual squares of the feature size mesh to be slightly larger than the smallest annotated defect. Click Start Training to open the Training Options window. We'll explore the individual settings in another video, so for now, simply click Start Training again. A dialog window will display a training chart. The graph should gradually decrease, indicating that the model is improving. The optimal time to stop the training is when the chart levels off and no longer decreases for a period of time. Click Finish Training, and the trained model will load. Go to the camera view and check process to see the live processing. As you can see, the result is not satisfactory, with the defects only partly identified. The most common reason for this is that the model was not trained on enough images or that the training was stopped prematurely. To improve the model's accuracy, we will add 2 more defect-free images and retrain the model. Create new images by replacing the defective screws and rotating others. Capture the images and return to the model view. Now select the training tab to return to the training view. Check include to add the first image. Then select the other image and check include as well. Click start training, and then click start training again. The include function allows you to add defect-free images or just the background into the training to reduce false positives. Remember, all annotations are considered defects, and everything else is treated as the background. Therefore, it's crucial to annotate all defects accurately. Stop the training when the chart flattens. Now, set the evaluation criteria that will determine how each image is assessed. When the specified conditions are met, the image will be classified as OK. Click the evaluation button and select the logical operator, which means that all the rules must be satisfied for an image to be considered OK. Click plus rule to add a new rule. We will select together, count, the equals sign, and 0, then click save and close. This rule essentially states that only images with 0 defects will be evaluated as OK. We'll cover all the available options in more detail in a separate video. To test the new model, go to the camera view and check process. We can now test the model, placing defective screw in various positions. While we train the model on just a few images to keep the example concise, it's important to note that achieving optimal results typically involves using a well-annotated dataset, allowing sufficient training time, and possibly conducting additional iterations for refinement. Thank you for watching. Try Peacock Vision now. Visit us at www.peacockvision.com or contact us at sales@peacockvision.com.